Hi! In the previous video of this two-part series, I showed you how to make a Uroflowmetry device for yourself. If you haven't seen the video, find it on my channel. In this video, I will show you how to use web interface, how to calibrate the machine, and how to use dedicated Windows program. Coming up!
Welcome to my YouTube channel GreenEyedExplorer, where I explore further and beyond about tweaks, hacks, electronics, and house repairs.
Hi, we will start by entering device address into web browser. Uroflow will ask for the username and password. By default, they are both admin. Click login. You enter them at first connection. The main site opens. Here is the medical report for free Uroflow version. In the input box, you can enter patient name to make it complete. You can see both graphs. You can check the slopes by moving the mouse over it. Detailed information is displayed. At the bottom, the About link. Click it. It opens the About page with some details about processor. This demo firmware runs on Espressif ESP32. At the bottom we can see all available links. We will move into Settings. Click it. Available options here are Wi-Fi settings, configuration and calibration, which we want at the moment. Be sure to follow the instructions. Firstly, remove everything from the scale. Press Calibration. Secondly, enter your calibration weight, but be sure to put the weight on the scale before pressing Enter. After entering, you have to wait approximately 30 seconds. At the end, we finish with the calibration factor, which has been saved into configuration file by now. Lastly, we just have to return our empty collecting mug on the tray. The Uroflow device will restart and you can start measuring. The other options we have in the About menu are View Configuration, Reset the Configuration, Reset Wi-Fi, Format File System, Restart, File Upload. If you edit any of the pages, just upload new ones. And Firmware Upload. Due to current state of software development kit, the firmware upload for now only works when using ESP8266. The main advantage of ESP32 is recording of 5-minute voiding time in opposite to ESP8266 where it is 1 minute, all due to RAM they have. Now I will simulate the patient voiding and pour water into the mug. When the LED turns off, we just have to press page refresh, that is F5 key. Here we can see the medical report. I will enter some name. Now we just have to press Ctrl plus P key for print preview and print it. Windows program. I wrote a 64-bit program for Windows. When you run it, first click the Connect button, then enter patient name and year of birth. The program is still under heavy development. Now press Read button. The report contains all the data. Now you can print it. You can also save the data in a database. We will open a random previous flow from the database. See, the data is different. Other options in the program are config with license key information and about menu. Now I will touch the machine to simulate voiding to show you that the program gives you a notice when the patient uses the Uroflow. The read button is disabled while voiding. At the end of the day, we just press disconnect and close the program. Here I have to mention the Windows program is intended for commercial usage. Outro. Thank you very much for viewing my video. You are invited to click like and leave a comment below. Share video with your friends, subscribe to my channel and support my work via Patreon. You can even buy me a coffee. See the links in the description.